Hello and welcome. Today, we're going to look at how you can publish content to SharePoint with NetHelp. This is a great publishing option because the web server, authentication, and security is already set up for you. When publishing to SharePoint, you basically have two options. First, you can publish NetHelp to a SharePoint document library. In this case, NetHelp basically behaves as it would if it were hosted on any web server. Or you can transform NetHelp to SharePoint Wiki pages. In this case, your content will appear in a SharePoint Wiki. In this video, we will take a quick look at both, starting with publishing to a document library. So let's get started. Many NetHelp users like to host NetHelp with SharePoint because they get built-in features such as security and version history. SharePoint is also a web server, so it is an easy way to host NetHelp. When you host NetHelp in SharePoint, you upload NetHelp files to an ordinary SharePoint document library. You then give users the URL to the default HTML file, and when that is opened, NetHelp loads and looks as if it would if it were hosted on an ordinary server. To get started, make sure NetHelp is the selected target on the home ribbon. In this project, we already have a built NetHelp target. If you don't have one, NetHelp will ask you to do so during the process. To publish to SharePoint, drop down the Publish menu and select Publish to SharePoint. The Publish to SharePoint wizard will open. Here we have two choices. We can upload NetHelp to a document library, or we can upload it to a SharePoint Wiki page library. For now, we're going to use a document library. We can type in the URL of our library directly, browse the SharePoint site to find it, or have NetHelp create one for us. Let's have NetHelp create one. We'll start by entering the base URL of the library, and then when we click the Browse button, NetHelp will show us the contents of the SharePoint site. All we need to do is create a new folder, and NetHelp will create that library for us. To publish, we just need to follow the instructions, and NetHelp will do all the work for us. Here is what your NetHelp target will look like in SharePoint. These are all the files that NetHelp uses, and they're stored in a SharePoint document library. When you open the index file, which is the default topic, NetHelp will open. You see, this is an ordinary NetHelp target. You can't even tell it's on SharePoint except for the URL. All you need to do is give your users the URL to this file, and they can access NetHelp as they normally would. Now, let's use the same project to create a SharePoint Wiki. The process for creating a wiki is the same as the process for publishing to a document library. So we'll go ahead and get the process started. We'll select the Publish to SharePoint item. And then this time, we'll select the wiki page library publishing type. And we will enter the URL of our SharePoint site. And we'll browse the site to find our wiki. And here it is, Employee Handbook. Then we click Next. And NetHelp will create a wiki from our NetHelp project. Once it is complete, we will open our wiki and see what it looks like. As you can see, the first page of my wiki is a table of contents. Each of these links leads to what was a topic in my NetHelp project. If I select one, you can see that all the formatting and links are intact. As you just witnessed, SharePoint publishing is an easy and great option for cases when you need a place to host NetHelp or when your content makes sense in the context of your SharePoint site. To learn more and download a free trial, go to NetHelp.com. Thanks for watching and thanks for choosing NetHelp.